series of Alan Carr Chatty Band. Yeah, look at this. What a week it's been. Because of the crisis in Syria, David Cameron had to come home early from his fourth holiday of the summer. What about those pictures of his sunburnt, chubby pink skin? But still, a nice serving suggestion for anyone considering roasting a tin of Spam this weekend. What I don't get is if Cameron's so keen to launch an attack on Syria, why doesn't he just tell Greg Wallace that President Assad tried to grope his girlfriend? Simon Cowell was photographed on a beach kissing the woman carrying his baby. Oh, he looked so awkward, didn't he?
He looked awkward, didn't he? Yeah.
In fact, when I saw the photos, I had to ask my mum and dad to get off in front of me just to get the image out of my head. No. There was a lot of talk about the toddler on the beach. It's not the baby, but Simon trying to walk in the sand in a Cuban flip-flop. Of course, Simon plans to be present at the birth, provided the hospital can find a surgical gown with a V-neck. No. He's such a playboy, when the waters break, he'll think it's an excuse to get his jet ski out, but it's... Speaking of babies, Edinburgh Zoo reckon their panda, Chan Chan, could be pre... That's Rodolfo, that's his name! Chan Chan could be... It's like wind chimes when I say it, isn't it? Chan Chan! Reckon their panda Chan Chan could be preg... Stop laughing, could be pregnant. And maybe about to give birth. Oh. It'd be interesting to see which is less hairy, the panda baby or Simon Cowell's. I saw a photo of the panda mum with her black eyes and I thought, pregnancy or no pregnancy, just leave him. And finally, can we talk about Cheryl Cole's new rose tattoo on her bum? Oh, don't. It looked like she was wearing a nappy made out of Mary Berry's floral bomber jacket. I like roses, but knowing Cheryl's run a bad luck, it'll probably get green fly. What a lineup we have for you tonight. I've got a globe full of Listerine at the ready for the pottiest mouth judge in X Factor history. Yes, Sharon Osbourne's in the house. I'll be talking to the business gurus who've made more dough than Russell Grant's local Greggs. That's right, the stars of Dragon Den will be here. And there'll be music from the brilliant Rizzle Kicks. But first, an actress and a comedian who are about to star in the funniest Essex farce since the vicar sat on Nanny Pat's sausage plat. Give it up for Keeley, Hawes and Lee Evans!
It's a very nice set as well, by the way.
But I'm still not finding my way around. I mean, do you want to have a little guided tour?
Shall I show you?
Let's have it. You've got some lamps. You chopped down a few trees and all.
Well, you know what? They're actually modelled on Kim Kardashian's ankles when she was pregnant. She's a friend. She's a family friend. She'll be laughing about this at home.
So, are we going to play Twister or...?
No, it's lovely. It's like grand designs in here, isn't it? It's
it is. It's
like, but a cheap version. What? I mean...
I'm fine. I pay for this set out of my own money.
Oh, that's why, then.
bastard.
What? Well, that's what it is.
Right, let me get you some drinks. What would you like, love?
Oh, what have you got?
Well, what haven't I got? I've got martini, I've got girl. Women only drink. I don't know what that means.
Why?
Lovely.
Yeah, women only?
I know.
I'll give it a go.
Yeah. Might be made of estrogen or something. You don't know these days. What do you want, love? I've got some mad dogs. Do you want some mad dogs?
Well, have you got any rabid dog?
Rabid? Yeah.
I want rabid mental dog.
Oh, yeah.
And thank you very much.
Yeah. Yeah. Fuck it. Yeah. I'm going to piss up that log.
What about Iron Brew? Iron Brew?
Iron Brew, yeah.
That's nice.
Thank you very much indeed. Thanks, Alan.
So what have you two been doing over the summer?
I was picking our nose and spitting a lot, haven't we?
Did you go on holiday or anything?
I went with the kids to Egypt before it was, you know, on fire.
It weren't you that kicked it all off, was it?
Nothing to do with me. No, so that was nice. It was very nice.
Oh,
actually.
Lovely.
Yes, 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 yes.
You know where I went? I went on safari. I took my mum on safari.
Whereabouts?
Windsor
I know
safari.
It sounds gay, but I... She always wanted to go, and of course, when we get to the place, it's called a lodge, isn't it, where you're there, obviously thought that me and my mum were husband and wife. Rose petals all over.
Is it a double room?
Yeah,
double
bed. Room.
King-size bed?
Yeah, me and my mum. Alan and Christine spelt out in roses.
That's lovely. Did your mum like it?
Yeah, we ended up making love. No, we didn't. No, we didn't. We didn't!
Are you sure?
No, well, maybe just a kick of the cuddle. Now, you two are doing a new play called Barking in Essex. Don't spoil it for me, as I haven't seen it yet. Tell us, what's it about?
Yeah, it's about this dysfunctional family, isn't it, living in Essex?
Yeah, you should come and see it. It's really funny and it's very serious. It's got a bit of pathos in
yeah,
it.
Yeah, yeah. Because you haven't done a play for ages, have you?
And no.
So what was it about this one that tickled your fancy?
Well, it sounds a bit sounds a bit crap, but I sort of read. I get a lot of plays sent to me.
Mm. And this do you one, love?
Yes, I do. Oh. Yeah. But this one was really funny, and I couldn't sort of put it down.
You said it's a cross between Ab Fab and The Sopranos.
Yeah.
Now
yeah.
I can't imagine Joanna Lumley whacking big pussy.
I can. It is very, very funny.
Mm. Yeah.
It is brilliant.
Well, you've shot a trailer for the play, so let's have a quick look. This is a little taste of Lee and Keeley embarking in Essex.
Yeah. Oh.
Theatre, darling, and step on it.
Roy, get your shit out!
Brilliant. You've both had proper Essex makeovers, haven't you? And Keeley, can I just say?
Yes.
How can I say it nicely? You make a lovely slag. Look at that. I bet even Miley Cyrus is looking at that thinking, she's gone too far. I mean... At stage school, you had elocution lessons.
I did.
To make you sound posh.
Well...
Well, yes, you do sound,
yeah.
Posher than him, anyway. have you had to learn all that to sound
Essex-y? I did a film with Jason Statham and I had to... And I played his wife, and so I played sort of Cockney.
Yeah.
Cockney.
Cockney.
it's sort of odd going the other way because you're, you know, when you've been taught how to speak in a certain way, although obviously I don't think about that when I speak, I just speak how I speak. But to then do something, you know, I mean, I'm not from Essex, so I never had an Essex accent in the beginning, but I had a London accent.
That's the trouble with elocution lessons. I really wish I'd never had them. Do you know what I mean? Because they really mess with my voice, you know.
Yeah. What did you sound like before?
Well, not like a pensioner.
Right.
I read you had to speak with a pencil in your mouth to sound posh.
Yes, certain vowel, you know, A, E, I, O. It's helpful.
Can you show me? Have you got a pencil or anything?
Oh, yeah, hang on.
Oh, no, sorry.
have you got one?
Oh, I haven't got a twiglet. Can you show me with a twiglet?
It's not really big enough, is it? Oh. You do it. Oh. Ready?
Now get it in there, because I've got so many gaps between my teeth. This could be.
Okay, say A-E-I-O.
A-E-I-O-U.
No, no, you have to stop at the O.
Why do you stop at the O?
Because I'm going to stick this in there. Oh. When I say
that. Oh, it's like Hungry Hippos. A-E-I-O-U.
But now I'll say O.
Oh, now you say O. Yeah.
So it's no. I don't need twiglets no more.
Keeley, I love your makeover with the old shell suit and the Lizzie Duke sovereign ring. I mean, look at that.
Yeah, that's sort of my character, really. in play.
No, thank you. But all I'm saying is, I worry, how sweaty are you going to get? You get sweaty anyway, well, but you're wearing a shell suit. You're going to be under these theatre lights. They're going to have to dip you into Lynx Africa before you go on stage. I mean, aren't you worried about how sweaty you're going to get?
No, because I'm wearing guttering. No, I'm not worried about that, because under there I'm wearing a bag and everything. So it collects it all. We take it out of town after the show's over and dump it in a place where no one can find it. Oh, just a minute. There you go, I've just filled the bag up for you.
What's the matter? You're basically saying you're wearing a tenor lady for sweat.
I am, that's exactly what I'm wearing. You won't
that's
even
not a bad idea.
Hey, wait a minute. You've got a point.
We got Dragon's Den later.
You have?
Yeah, come back and say, hi, it's a tenor lady for sweat.
50% of your business. I think a G-string version. G-string?
Will you be wearing
piss catcher?
No way.
What's the matter?
You dragged this show to an all-time low.
Listen,
I'm saying something.
I've dragged it up, mate.
I had to geezer up.
Geezer up?
Yeah, you know, like you did with the shell suit and the Lizzie Duke.
Oh, yeah.
For a photo shoot the other week, did you see?
Which one are you?
Great.
You look very butch there, I've got
to
say.
Thank you, thank you.
You would last 5 minutes round our way, but there we are.
I could be your understudy if you get ill, couldn't
you
I?
You could. Can you be all like hard then?
Yeah, all right. What's up, like. Oh. Oh, that was a twiglet. That was the twiglet gone the wrong way. You slag.
That's it. That's it. It's very good, that
oh,
is.
Oh, you slag. Oh, so, I'm
it's
turning
sort of
myself
doing something
on.
For me, yeah.
It's like a dirty phone call. I might give you a ring later. Yeah,
give me your number, Lee.
Yeah.
Hello, Lee. You slag.
I've got me piss catching G string on.
Wrong number. While you're doing the play, you're writing your new stand-up tour, Monsters.
Monsters.
Yeah. And you don't half pick these big venues. And I heard that's why you called it Monsters, because you play these monsters of a venue, but also the monsters in your head that you say talk to you.
Yes. You're saying something now, actually.
It's not kill, is it?
It is. Hold on. No, it's, you know, I can't stop working. Yeah. So you just, I have to sort of, and that's why I call it Monsters. I sort of worry about things at night and think about stuff and do a bit of music that's why I call him Monsters.
Well, I'm glad you've got those monsters in your head.
Yes.
Because we love him, don't we? Thank you so much. Good luck with the play. When's it start again? Next Friday?
We start previews next Friday,
oh,
yes.
Oh, wonderful. Give it up for Keeley Hawes and Lee Evans, everyone.
Well done, Keeley.
I'll do after the break, the Dragons, Sharon Osbourne and Rizzle Kicks will be here. See you in part two. Welcome back. Sharon Osbourne and Rizzle Kicks will be here soon. First, though, they're the multi-millionaires who fingered more 50s than a gigolo at a loose women rap party. Put your hands together for the stars of the Dragon's Den is Peter Jones, Duncan Bannatyne, Deborah Meaden and Kelly Hoppen! Right, let's get some drinks on the go. What do you fancy?
The gold sofa.
Yeah, because you were on the last, well, two of you were. I mean, is it an improvement? Do you like it?
Wow, very, very bling. Love it.
Very expensive.
Because you did the Beckham's house, didn't you?
I did.
Is it true, £20 million budget?
You can spend a lot of money in IKEA for £20
million. In IKEA? Because you could use Posh as an Allen key. Anyway, now let's get some drinks on the go. Noily Pratt. I don't know why I looked at you, Duncan. I'm sorry, but.
Well,
what is it? What's
this? Do you have a single malt whiskey?
Yeah, you open that and I'll get these drinks going. Oh, there you go. And you're having. What did you want again?
I'm going to have a Bucks Fizz, I think.
Okay, wicked, yeah, yeah.
My cork's about to pop. Where do you want it?
Oh, no, not in my face! No! Lovely. Right, I'll have a sidekick. Don't mind me. Let me just quickly go on with this.
Well, what's that?
Oh, don't tell me you want some sidekick,
Debbie. What is it?
It's the ultimate vodka mix with choc mint flavour.
Oh, I might have that after.
You didn't offer us that, did you?
No.
Is that your own private? It is, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, no. Cheers.
Cheers, Dragons.
Can I say it's taken you to get us back together again? Because we haven't seen each other since.
Since we finished filming.
It's nice to have you here, Duncan, because you were meant to come on the show last time.
Yeah, and I got a better offer. Yeah.
So it weren't a heart attack?
No.
You lied to me to get out of coming on chatting.
It was a holiday in France.
You don't.
Oh, sorry.
What is that?
You have to talk loud. It's Duncan.
Yeah, he said you're on holiday in France. You think you have a heart attack?
No, it wasn't a heart attack. It was I had a condition, but it wasn't a heart attack. But I had a stress attack.
Because Theo was here when he said you had a strain on your wallet. Because it's all change again, isn't it, in the den?
Is.
I mean, you have more different lineups than the Sugar Babes. You do. So what's happened to Theo? He's gone back to Ryman's.
Theo felt that I think he needs to put more effort into his business. We do miss Theo.
Yeah.
He's a lovely, wonderful man.
Although I've taken his chair.
Oh, have
so
you?
I missed him for about...
I wouldn't have taken his chair.
An hour?
I wouldn't have gone that far. No, I wouldn't have taken
his chair.
No, I should not.
We had to scrap over the chair.
Why, what's so amazing about Theo's chair? It's in the middle. Oh, so it's not like one of those ones that's like a massage that you can sit there like
that. What does that?
A service station's just sitting there going like that and people think you have a stroke. Hillary's gone as well. Now, reading between the lines, none of you lot seem that bothered that she's gone.
Don't look at me.
I know you weren't there, Kelly. But...
I like Hillary.
Yeah.
She's a very nice lady.
She's a lovely
Hillary.
Lady.
Yeah, I like Hillary.
Sorry, Duncan?
I like Hillary.
Do you want look at the camera and say that?
I like Hillary.
Yeah, but there was a bit of friction between... I didn't know whether you didn't like her or it was, like, sexual tension.
No, she's nice, she's lovely, but she happened to be late a few times. It did cause problems.
Oh, why do you reckon she was late?
I don't know.
Is it those shoulder pads weighing her down? Now, this newbie here, Piers. He looks too young to be a millionaire. How old is he? He looks about 12.
How old he is. He's great, though.
How old is he? I don't know.
38, 39.
No, he's 40-something.
No way. I thought he had, like, a paper round or something. Look at him. You seem to be competing with him to be a bastard. Have you noticed? In that den, he called that woman a numpty. What? You've been throwing things on the bloody floor. You're like a kid who's had too much Arabo.
But when you get things
like... What is up with you? You just turned all nasty.
But when you get ideas, you're sitting there for 20 minutes and it's like, this idea is not going to work. Why won't it work? Well, it's an inflatable anchor. It's just not going to work.
Why are so many businessmen bastards? I mean, you've got Donald Trump, you've got JR, Ian Beale. You have got that toughness about you. I mean, I do feel sorry for some of the people who come in.
It's not tough, it's being truthful.
You're sitting there and you've got all these people going, some people have amazing ideas, but it is a business show wrapped into entertainment. And sometimes people come on with the most ridiculous ideas and you can't pretend. You've got to be honestly nice-ish.
Ish.
Yeah. You know, you've got to be honest.
Because I like that umbrella with the washing underneath. Oh my God!
No.
I did!
No. 5 years. 5 years to put a cover over an existing washing line.
But it was an umbrella as well.
No.
If it rains, you put it up.
Have you bought one since?
Well, I'm trying to find one, but you all poo-pooed it, poor sod. I mean, do you get people coming up to you with ideas? Because Well, you know my other half. He's always coming up with good ideas.
He had one tonight.
Really? Yeah. What is it?
Well, he's going to come on the den and pitch it, so I can't tell you.
No, I don't want him doing that. His other idea, just so you know, is an airbag full of makeup, so if you have a crash...
I'd invest in that.
Can you imagine that? Ah! Oh! Just crashed my car, looking hot. Why have you got a lot of girls in bikinis and scantily clad dancers this series? They seem to be more than usual. Do you know what I mean? It's like da 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 da. Yeah, toilet roll holder.
Come on. I suppose they think that sexiness sells, don't they?
Well, it does, doesn't it?
Well, it does, but when you see the product, I don't know whether it does. I mean, it did in this occasion. It got an investment and it's doing well, so it works.
It was relevant. They're in bikinis and it's a tanning product.
Yeah.
Yeah, but Duncan's got a heart condition, haven't you, Duncan?
No, I don't. I have a stress condition. I don't know about my heart. It's absolutely perfect. Oh, okay. I can just look at scantily clad girls if I like, so it doesn't matter.
Have you thought about doing an X-rated show like Dragon's Den Nights?
Dirty Den.
Oh, I'd love to. Yeah, I'll give you 50% of your company. Throw in your wife. That'd be good. Good luck with the rest of the series. I'm absolutely loving it. Thank you so much. It's the Dragons, everyone. After the break, Sharon Osbourne and Rizzle Kicks will be here. See you in part three. Welcome back. Rizzle Kicks will be performing later. First, though, she's the outrageous, tough-talking judge who's guaranteed to bring more highlights to the X Factor than Louis Walsh's hair. Give it up for Sharon Osbourne!
Stairs. Can't do stairs, not in those silly shoes.
Because last time you were on, I gave you some slippers.
I know.
And I haven't got any this time.
Have we got then? What do we get?
We get a nice drink.
Well, come on then.
Hello. Do you want Moe? Or do you want Sours with a Z?
What's that?
It's spirited mango.
No.
You want Moe?
Yes.
Right, just wait.
Let's have a little drink, eh? And we should have drinks for everyone.
Yeah! my God, it's like opening time at Primark's down there. And you're back over here for the new series of The X Factor.
Yes.
Starts tomorrow. No!
Did it hit anyone?
That hit a man in the front row.
Sue!
Yeah.
Shut up!
Sue!
You've been in America too long.
Yeah, you've been too. Where there's blame, there's a bloody claim. You've got enough awry, it's fine. Right, what can I get you? I'll have to use these
this
glasses,
is fine,
love.
Fine,
are you sure, love?
Yes,
are you sure? Well, yes. I want to be a good host.
Come on.
There you go. Let me just get that there.
Then. Fabulous.
Oh, fabulous, darling. Okay, just sorry this is not. Oh, my God, there. I'll pour it out because it's all frizzing over. I'm so sorry. Oh, my God, I'm so sorry. There you go. Oh, darling, I'm turning to Patsy from Ab Fab. There we go. So, X Factor starts tomorrow night.
Yes.
You're the new judge. So, how did you get your old job back? Because I heard that you said to Simon, you know his name.
Actually, I was being sarcastic. Somebody did ask me, and I said that just because I was being sarcastic. No, he brought me back because he knows I'm fabulous. That's all.
Oh, it
speaks for itself. Fabulous. Well, agree with me. Don't just sit there. Really, you just sit there in silence.
Because I thought with that sucking off thing, I thought, you know what? They should introduce that to The Apprentice because it'd make it snappier, wouldn't
yes.
it?
No, no, no. Those years are well gone.
What, oh. You don't do that anymore?
Dear, no. Ridiculous.
Last year's X Factor, let's
yes.
be honest, it was a bit... wasn't it? And it got beaten by Strictly in the ratings. What's the mood like in the X Factor camp?
Well, you
time.
See, I wasn't here. I never saw it. However, however, it's quite fantastic now. It's amazing. They've made amazing changes in the format. It's all different. It's all yeah. new. And the first episode, I'm naked.
No way!
Yes way!
Oh, my God!
Yes way!
Naked, and you're behind the desk,
I
are you naked?
I borrowed Sunita's leaves, didn't I?
Oh, my God.
But the thing is, they hide hers, but they don't hide mine.
Oh, so you've got a bit of boobage hanging out the
oh,
side.
Oh, out of those leaves, it's fabulous.
Oh, my...
Just you wait.
And is it true the producers have already worked overtime bleeping out all your swearing? Well, apparently it's like Morse code spelling fuck off.
Get it in the heat of the moment. I'm yeah. trying to express myself.
Yeah.
And there's no better way to express yourself other than a quick fuck, is there?
Yeah. That, do you know what? Hell yeah. Yeah. A quick yeah. fuck here and a quick,
no, quick fuck there.
Yeah.
And if a contestant get on me nerves, I go, oh, fuck off. Get out. Yeah. Be gone. Really? Make haste, quickly. Fuck off.
Well, you've already snapped. I heard that you attacked a pensioner with a biro.
I did too.
No.
And it showed with a knife. Really?
Why did you attack a poor pensioner?
Because this old bloke comes in and starts slagging my old man, so I'm like, here, what can I throw at you? So I'm like, you can fuck off.
Yeah.
No.
Two bloody slags off Aussie in front of you. I mean, it's
well,
like...
They know what they're going to get.
Yeah,
right?
It's like dangling a party sausage in front of a Rottweiler. You're going to get bitten.
That's right.
Oh.
How dare he. And I'm nearly a pensioner, so fuck him.
Yeah.
Yeah. Age is no matter.
No.
Right?
Yeah. These old people, they want equality, don't they?
Yeah. You want it, you bloody got it.
Yeah, yeah. We've got a clip here. This is Sharon in action on
oh,
the X Factor.
Go on, I haven't seen any of it.
Hello!
Hi there. What's your name?
Andy.
OK, what are you going to sing today?
Air Hostess by Busted.
Great, good luck.
Hostess, I like the way you dress. You know, I hate to fly, but I feel much better. Occupy my mind, then you a love letter that messed my pants when we flew
you
over.
Mess you messed your pants. That's quite fabulous. You messed your pants.
And I like the way Nicole was moving your drink away as if you'd been drinking. Had you been drinking?
A little. One gets thirsty doing that all day long.
And you said that Elton John keeps you entertained, doesn't he? By sending you filthy, filthy pictures and texts.
He sent me this thing, and it's a Brazilian farting website. And there's this one lady, and she's voluptuous, and she's farting up a storm, and there is this other lady who's very tiny with her nose. She's got a big nose, and it's right up this woman's bum. I cannot believe that you would send me this, but I'm happy he did, because it's amazing.
Sounds like Brazil's Got Talent, doesn't it? Like an audition.
Yeah.
He's naughty, isn't he? How are you getting on with the other judges? Because you haven't always got on with them in the past, have you? We all know.
Not that old chestnut
again. I want you to clear the air.
Oh, no.
No, that's no, why okay. She's here tonight. Ladies and gentlemen, Danny Mc... No. No. Dan, I thought you were going to bite my ear like Hannibal Lecter.
No, you wouldn't get any shits and giggles out of that one, tell you. The best. Yeah. The best panel.
Yeah.
Nobody is more exotic and sexy and talented than Nicole.
Oh, yeah.
Gary Barlow, I bow down to him. Yeah. He's never done a show that I haven't seen.
No.
Not sexually, but performance.
Yeah.
I adore him. He is so talented. I absolutely adore him.
Yeah.
And Louis, well. And it's Louis.
Of course, Lulu.
We call Louis Mr. X because he is Mr. X Factor.
Yeah. I've been to some clubs where he's performing as Mrs. X. But, And Louis said, you've come back looking younger than when you left. Have you had more work done, or is he being a bitch?
He's just being... He goes, you're old, you know. You're old, you know. But you look all right. But you're old, you know. I'm like... Fuck off.
Well, he's a bloody talk. Who does he think? Benjamin O'Button. Look at him.
I know.
Now, Louis's got the boys, hasn't he, with this category?
He does. Yes,
I mean, now that's normally a strong category. How's he going to screw it up? You know what?
You are so naughty by saying that. No, he won't. He's fabulous. Louis picks all the great songs, yes.
And where are you going to pretend to live this time on Judge's Island?
Okay.
That's what I want to know.
Okay. I would just like to make an official statement. Official, this is. I was the only judge who ever did anything in their own home.
Really?
Really. Ooh. And I'm doing it again in my own home.
Oh, with all the dog shit everywhere.
Can all come in, they'll all be squelching shit.
Yeah.
It's
going to be hard to sing I Will Always Love You with a turd between your toes. We've got to take a break there,
why?
Sharon.
Why?
Well, we just have to. We have to have a
break
part
the
four.
Rule.
No!
Don't conform, Alan.
Well,
don't.
Do I look like the face of conformity? Join us again in a couple of minutes when I'll be chatting some more with Sharon, and Rizzle Kicks will be dropping by and performing. See you in part four. Welcome back to part four. Rizzle Kicks will be here in a mo, but look who's still here. It's Sharon effing Osbourne.
Yes!
Let's have a bit more. Now, before the break, we were talking about X Factor.
Yes.
And you're flying. Is that true? You're flying back and forth from America to here.
Yes. I leave on a Thursday night and I go back Monday morning every week.
Oh, my God.
Oh, I know. All those air miles.
Oh, yeah. But who's looking after Ozzy when you're here?
Well, when I start X Factor Live,
yeah,
he's going to be touring Europe. So we're going to be seeing each other. Oh. Yes. And he's going to be performing in London.
Oh.
Yes.
Oh. No. I must ask, how are things with you and Ozzy? Because you did it a rough patch, didn't you, recently?
Oh, he's such a naughty old bastard, isn't he? That bloody drink, and you just have to put your foot down.
Yeah, yeah.
So I put my foot down and I said, that's it, I'm off until you're a year sober.
Yeah.
I gave up after 3 months and went back.
Yeah. Really? Yeah. Oh, yeah. Bless. Now, Sharon, you're going to have to budge up a bit because it's time to get... Because it's not all about you.
Yes, it is. What the bloody hell is going on now?
Because it's time to get out my other guests.
And do they sing?
Yes.
Can I sing with them?
Oh. I was going to have a biro thrown at them.
Oh. Are you a pensioner?
We've got the brilliant Rizzle Kicks. Come on down.
What, you're sure? I was told I have to sit in
the... No, go on.
All right. All right, so, thank you. Thank
now,
you,
you're Sharon. Performing for us in a minute.
Yes.
Now, do you want a quick drink? Can you drink and rap? Is that legal?
I don't know, what have you got?
I've got some Moe on the go, I've got Noilly Pratt, I've got Bailey's. What else? I've got Martin. Do you like a martini?
I like a Bailey's, actually.
Yeah, sure. What do you want?
I brought my scratched up beer thing, so I'll be your cool with this.
You know what that means, don't you, when you scratch the label off?
What's it mean?
I kind
sexually of... Sexually frustrated.
No, it was for...
It does.
It was for labelling purposes, I swear.
Bullshit.
It was.
Go off and have a wank or
something. All right.
I've only got those little glasses. So is that all right? Do you want a Bailey's or you're
fine,
right?
What kind of glass is that? It looks like a toy one.
I know.
It's manly.
Kids.
No, it's the one I put my sample in when I go to the clinic. Don't judge.
Really?
Okay, so how are you doing? Have you been doing all the festivals and everything?
Yeah, we've done a few this year. Yeah. We went, like, outside of the UK as well, which is always exciting. Mm. Spain, Benicassim, we did. And whatever, Ibiza rocks, Mallorca rocks.
It's been a fun summer.
Ibiza's always fun.
And we're doing like Jamie Oliver's festival at the weekend, which I'm really excited about.
Jamie Oliver?
Yeah, big fish.
He's branched out into bloody everything. Now he's doing festivals.
He started off as a drummer, Jamie Oliver, in a band. Yeah,
he's got a festival.
Yeah, festival.
Ridiculous.
It's about Alex James from Blur, and they got, like, it's called the Big Festival.
What is happening in the world today?
Yeah, well, don't you sit on that fence, Sharon, you say how you feel.
No, I like him, he's lovely.
He's really safe, actually.
Now, X Factor starts tomorrow.
Right.
But you two aren't exactly its biggest fans, are you?
Oh, I thought you might bring this up.
Tell me everything now. I want to know everything. Come on,
we just basically...
It's Alan Carr Chatty Man, not Sharon Osbourne. Zip it!
You know that, sir. That was quite mean, actually. You're right.
Am I right?
You're
right. Go on, you can tell me, I can hear.
Okay.
No. No, you called Louis a puppet.
Oh, yeah. Listen, listen, listen. Let me
explain. He's never had a hand.
Let me explain myself. Listen. Listen, what I meant, can I just explain myself here?
What I meant with Louis was that, like,
yeah. I think puppet and taken out of context sounds very harsh. I was just a little bit perturbed by the fact that he's responsible for, say, Jedward, which I'm not, like, I don't like the fact that Jed would, like, have a career.
Yeah.
And I feel No, they're cool kids. I just think it's, you know, they should be doing something else.
I know what you're saying.
Yeah. X Factor's all right. Like, some of our, like, obviously our first big break, one of our first big breaks was on an Ollie Murs song, and he's awesome, man. Like, he's one of the hardest working people we know. And for that...
I like him.
You like Ollie?
Yeah, we like Ollie. Anyway, you're performing in a minute,
yeah?
And what with all the fuss about Miley Cyrus, the Channel 4 lawyers have asked me, are you going to be twerking?
On stage?
Yeah, or touching yourself with a sponge finger. She's actually coming on my show, so she wants to learn how to twerk. But do you know how
it is the in thing at the moment?
It's like, yeah. you like go or something. I don't know how to do it. I can't do it at all. I can't actually...
Twerking, is it like fracking?
What's fracking?
I don't know.
Same as fucking.
Yeah. It's fucking a twat.
I don't know how to do it. So you like wiggle, look, you go like this and you wiggle your bum.
Yeah. is that actually moving? Because I can't tell. Something's moving, but... You know, I've been diagnosed with a lazy buttock. Is that moving?
Yeah, do you know what?
Is that...
yeah, it's moving.
Carly, what have I told you about that?
Sorry. I think it exists.
Now something's working.
We're not going to be twerking, don't worry. But... I like dancing, though.
Yeah. Well, we're going to see that right now because you're going to perform for us.
Yes, we are. So,
you're going to get ready. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Sharon.
That's it for tonight's show. A massive thank you to Lee Evans and Keeley Hawes, the Dragons, and of course, the one and only Sharon Osbourne. On next week's show, I'll be joined by Channing Tatum, Jamie Foxx, David Walliams, and there'll be music from Maya, Keisha and Siobhan. But now we're Lost Generation. It's Rizzle Kicks!
TV to keep it real, but not in that way. I turn the channel and just see somebody's life display. Awkward pauses and dodgy moments, I smile, it keeps me sane. Reality TV is morphine, give me that now, let me ease the pain. Man, talent shows have seen some of our friends go beat their targets. I've also seen careers end where they ain't even really started. Jeremy Carl got the nation up and at other people's expense. Somebody tell that guy that we make him too. We are not his friends. Yeah, hashtag trend. We make people go clap clap, yeah. When I heard people buy views, I was more confused than all John Terry's black friends.
Oi, watch your mouth, son.
Hashtag trend. Oi, big brothers in the house now, yeah. I said screw the voting and talking. Now let's want to see people fight and have sex. So let's say hey.
I'm living life.
Say hey. Stupid. Yeah. a slut, you know this, but I'm a boy, it's all good. Take snaps of me, I'm an icon, I'm standing here with my shades. Baby, be someone, if you beg to be followed, then you've lost your way. Yeah, hashtag trend. We make people go clap, clap, yeah. Why is everybody so PC? It's not my fault if you take offense. Hey, watch your mouth, son. Hashtag